Welcome to a beginner's guide to cataract surgery. This video is aimed for any clinician or student looking to gain insight into the basic steps of cataract surgery. So what is a cataract? It's essentially a pacification or clouding of the crystalline lens in the eye that causes visual problems. A cataract affects the way that light passes through the eye and it can lead to a gradual painless loss of vision and contrast sensitivity over time. Patients may also report symptoms of glare in bright light and there may be a myopic shift in the patient's glasses prescription. The treatment is surgery whereby an ophthalmologist removes the cataract and replaces it with a lens implant. In this video, I'll be showing a patient that I operated on, and following the operation, the patient's vision improved from about 636 to 65 on the cilindro. So for this case, I've opted for sub-tenons local anaesthetic and I've cleaned and prepared the patient with a drape. We're able to identify the main structures, cornea, iris, and the lens. Just to orientate you, the patient is lying supine and I'm looking down a microscope at the top of the patient's head. The first step of the operation is to make a corneal incision. It's critical to ensure that this is a well-constructed wound. I'm using a 2.75mm keratome and performing a stepped incision. This is to ensure that it's a watertight wound with no leaks. I next fill the anterior chamber with viscoelastic. This is a biopolymer which creates and maintains the space in the anterior chamber. I also make a second side port paracentesis, and this is for my second instrument. It's a smaller stab incision and I tend to put it about 60 degrees from my main corneal incision. The next stage is performing a continuous curvilinear capsulorhexis. So I'm using a 25 gauge needle to puncture the capsule and lift a small flap. I'm using a forceps to pick up the flap and pull it round slowly to create access to the cataract. Ideally, this needs to be about 5 to 6 millimeters in diameter and centrally located. The capsule is a basement membrane rich in type 4 collagen, and it's quite difficult to see in this video. So I've included another video of a case where I've used Vision Blue dye, and this is to stain the capsule blue. We tend to use this for much denser cataracts where there's a poor red reflex. Hopefully with the capsule stained blue, you're able to appreciate the way that I'm performing the capsulorhexis.
Listen, man.
Now that we have access to the cataract, we need to gently separate it from the capsule using a technique called hydrodissection. I'm using a blunt cannula and I'm going just under the capsule and injecting fluid to loosen and free the lens. This will allow me to manipulate and rotate the lens, which is essential for the next stage. Now we move on to phacoemulsification. This is where the cataract is broken down with ultrasonic energy and aspirated through a small probe. This is a small handpiece and it's controlled with my right foot like a car pedal. I can control irrigation, aspiration and phaco energy. With my left foot, I'm controlling the microscope. The phaco probe consists of a hollow titanium needle with an enclosing cooling sheath. You can see that I'm holding the handpiece with my right hand and the second instrument, which is a chopper, in my left. I start by sculpting two perpendicular grooves. I'm being very careful with my depth and I'm aiming for about 3 millimeters depth centrally. I don't want to touch or damage the posterior capsule as this is a very important structure in supporting my lens implant. There are many different techniques that can be used to remove a cataract. I'm using a technique called divide and conquer here. Essentially, this means that I divide the cataract up into four quadrants and then remove them individually. Now that I've created a cross, I can now move on to cracking. This is where I use both my instruments to separate and crack the cataracts into four quadrants. Once the cataract has been broken down into smaller quadrants, I'm able to emulsify them using the Phaco probe. You can see here I've chosen to go for the smallest quadrant first, and I'm using the vacuum to bring the quadrant to my probe, bringing the piece into the safe zone of the anterior chamber, and only then using the Phaco energy to break it down. I also use my second instrument to manually chop the quadrant, and this is to try and help reduce the amount of Phaco energy I'm using in the eye. The pedal controlling the Phaco probe is like a car accelerator pedal. I'm listening out for the sounds that the Phacoemulsification machine is making, like an engine, such as if the probe is occluded or how much vacuum I'm using. You can see these changes visually on the screen. Now that the bulk of the cataract has been removed, you can see that the red reflex is already significantly brighter. But there's still some outer lens cortex that needs removing, and I'm using the irrigation and aspiration probe to remove it. I'm engaging the cortex, bringing the probe into the center, and using the vacuum to peel away the cortex matter. I'm now using more viscoelastic, but this time I'm putting it into the capsular bag, and this is to create a nice inflated space to allow me to put the intraocular lens into the eye. This is the acrylic intraocular lens implant, and it's already folded and prepared in an injector which is ready for insertion. As I insert it into the capsular bag, I'm trying to facilitate it unfolding in the correct place, and this is by making sure both the haptics, which are the arms of the lens, are gently guided into the correct position. I'm now removing the rest of the viscoelastic in the eye. Any left behind could lead to a raised intraocular pressure postoperatively. I'm now using a balanced salt solution to hydrate the corneal wounds, and this is to ensure that there's no leakage. If the wound is leaking and it's not watertight, there is the option of using a corneal suture, however these are rarely used in routine operations. And then possibly one of the most important steps of the operation to reduce the risk of infection, and that's antibiotics. I'm giving intracameral cefuroxim, which is a broad spectrum third generation cephalosporin, and a few drops of steroids to finish, and we're done. So this was an example of a routine cataract operation. The patient was discharged on the same day with topical steroid and antibiotic drops, and 6 weeks later the patient had a visual acuity of better than 6.6. Thank you very much for watching. It's good to keep in mind that there are many different ways of performing cataract surgery. I know that I'm always learning and improving my own techniques, but hopefully this basic guide will give you a good starting point. Thanks again for watching.